welcome once again, and I received most of your posted questions on my email. I found out that most of you were eager to get more examples on these polar and irregular forms of complex numbers. Don't worry, the questions you post, I'm about to answer some of them, and I'll give others out as an assignment for you to practice. It's good to practice because practice always makes what? Perfect. So without wasting my time, let's take some basic examples of transforming or changing complex numbers from the rectangular form to polar form, as well as what? Irregular form. For example, you'll be given a complex number, which is z equals 1 plus r. You have to change this into polar and irregular form. How do we do that? From our previous lesson, we said anytime you have the rectangular form, you first draw a what? Complex plane with our imaginary axis and with our real axis. And we try to plot the complex number on the complex plane. So we have 1 here, so we mark our 1 on the real axis. And we have I, which is 1i. Of course, we don't write that 1. So 1i, 2, 4 on the imaginary plane. So we can say both meet here, and we have our complex number z here. And we say we label the length here r. And look, the distance from the origin to the 1 is still what? A magnitude of 1. And from the origin to I is also another magnitude of 1. So with this, we can find our r. Now let's find out what r will be first. So our r was given by the square root of a squared plus b squared. And here our a is 1 and our b is also 1, as we can see represented here on the diagram. So our r becomes the square root of 1 squared plus 1 squared, which is eventually 1 plus 1 under square root, and gives us square root of 2 as our final answer. So r has the magnitude of square root of 2. Now the second thing we need to find is the angle theta, which the complex number makes with the positive real axis. And we also wrote that to find theta, we need to use tan of the theta, which is equal to the b over a in this case. So our tan theta will be 1 over 1, because we still have our b to be 1, our a also is what, 1. So we have 1 over 1, which is eventually 1. So theta becomes tan inverse of 1. And what will be tan inverse of 1? We only get our calculator and punch tan inverse of 1. But please don't forget, let your calculator be in radian mode, because we always use radian angles in such computation. We don't use degrees. So always check that your angular mode is in radian mode. So tan inverse of 1 gives us 1/4 of pi, which is pi over 4. So our theta is pi over 4 in radians. So with this, we can find the polar form and the irregular form. Now we know in polar form we have z to be equal to r cos theta plus I sine theta. And we know r to be root of 2, and we know r theta to be pi over 4, or 1/4 pi. So we substitute them into the relation or equation here, then we are done with the polar form. So this becomes the polar form of the complex number z equals 1 plus r. And the Euler form as well, we know for Euler form we have r, the natural e to the power I theta. So we still have r to the 2 root of 2. So we place our root of 2 here. We maintain our natural e, we maintain our I, and theta as we know is 1/4 pi. So we can rewrite this as root of 2 e to the power 1/4 pi I. That is in algebraic form. So this one becomes our Euler form.